The Bible says in the book of Genesis that the Word, God created everything with what? With the Word. So if He created everything with the Word, when something goes wrong, what can fix that thing? The Word. So the source of whatever creates something, that's where you go to fix it when something goes wrong. So most of you guys don't read your Bible, don't spend the time reading your Bible. I want to teach you about the Word for you to understand the importance of the Word of God. Why we should read the Bible. Amen? It's very important. A lot of you believe in prophecy. Oh, I love prophecy. I believe prophecy is part of me. Word of knowledge, I believe in it. I believe in vision and the power of God. It's part of me. But one thing that keeps you going the right way is when you're reading the Word of God. Only the Word of God can help you understand when you're going to the straight path, when you're going to the right way. If someone is not spending time in the Word of God, I'm telling you, the enemy will deceive you. Amen? You will be deceived, believe it or not. The Bible declares in the book of Genesis chapter 3 that the Satan, he was the most wisest one among all the beasts. This man was, Satan is very smart. He's very wise. So how do you fight somebody that has been there for centuries? For hundreds and thousands of years, the devil has been there on earth. You only what, 20, 30, 40, 50. So how do you fight something like that? So only the Word of God will help you. Now what is the Word of God? Let me explain something. Let me show you. Let me start that way. And all of you would know. Do you know about Beyonce? What do you know about Beyonce? Come here. Go ahead, all of you. She's a singer. She's from Houston. As the white person, right? Jesus. See how much she knows about Beyonce? Now let's find out, how do you know about Beyonce? Have you met her? So she never met Beyonce, but she knows about Beyonce. How do you know so much about Beyonce? She reads Facebook, all kind of things. So whenever you're reading and you're doing research, look how she knows about someone without ever, never met that person. So God has done the same thing. God wrote a book about himself. And he said, those who want to know him, if you want to know the way he is, and if you want to be his friend, he said, first of all, you have to start by reading my book. And he said, I tell you all about myself in my book. Without my book, you will not know me, because there's many. How do you call those people with the whatever they call them? Yeah, there's a lot of them out there, which is the devil, the Satan, and demons. You know what they do? They wanna give God another image that He's not. So, and God tells you, for you to know who He is, start reading the Word of God. Only the Word will tell you the truth about Him, because there's a lot of false things out there. They will tell you all kind of things. And the only way for you to have a straight path is only when you start reading about the Word of God. How many of you know someone that used to be in church and that don't want to have anything to do with church? All because of church folks. Because of the way people treat others in church. Sometimes people use the Word of God just to destroy someone else. In their own benefits. To tell you, to just show you your life. Hey, you are messed up. You are this, you that. The Bible says this about your situation. And the person end up not coming back to church. That's what I'm saying. Because people will use the Word of God. Now, if you don't know scriptures, if you don't know the Word of God, what you will do? You will think what they say is true. And you feel that, man, how can they talk to me that way? And I will never come back to church. But yet, the church was supposed to be in a hospital. When you feel crazy, when things are going crazy out there, and for you to come run to the hospital for healing. But if we don't know the Word of God, people will use the Word of God, will quote even the verses in the Bible. The Bible said in Matthew chapter 4 that when the devil came to Jesus, you know what he used? The Word of God. The devil opened his Bible in Psalm 91. See, the Bible knows, the devil knows the Psalms as well. That's what he quote, Psalm 91, and to come and tempt Jesus. So now imagine someone come to you and said, the Bible says this. This is what God says. How will you know it's the truth? How can you tell the difference between that voice and that voice when both voices are used in the Bible? Are you there with me? Can I continue with this? So the word of God is very important for you to know, because the devil, there's a problem with the devil. He can only use the Bible twisted in his benefits, because he will never use it in your benefit somehow for you to benefit something from the Bible. He will only use the Bible in a way twisted and for you to fall in his trap. But now if you don't know the Bible, and you will be deceived. That's the reason when people said, man, you have to be careful with people that are prophesying with prophets. I just laugh. Because the only reason you have to be careful, because if you don't know the word of God. Because God will never do something outside of his word. My Bible already tells me in 1 Corinthians chapter 14 that when someone is prophesying, what should I expect from that? Then if what I'm supposed to expect is not coming from the prophecy, I already know it's from the devil. The Bible said, do not add anything, do not take anything out. Anything that you add or take out is from where? The evil one. So when you know the Bible, you will know what to expect when someone is speaking to you. Or when someone is using the word of God for their own benefits. People use the word of God to make money. So if you don't know the word of God, how will you know? You will fall in all kind of traps. I know if you know how to pray well. Prayer has nothing to do with that. It has to do with the word of God. What are you praying about? Is it part of the word of God? Because prayer is a petition. It's made known something to God. To tell God, this is what you say in your word. To tell God about his own word. But how do I tell God about his word if I don't know the word? How do I tell God this is what he says in his word about my life if I have no idea what the word says? The Bible said in John the first chapter that the word become flesh. And when you read the word so much, you eat the word so much, and you spend too much time with the word, what you read, it becomes flesh. You're reading about healing, and healing will manifest. You're reading about finance will manifest. A lot of people believe that just because they came to church and something great was supposed to happen for them. No, it's not true. That's not the word of God says. Just because you come to church, it doesn't mean financially you're going to be stable. It doesn't mean something great will happen for you. It does not mean that. Now, if you don't know the word of God, your enemy will destroy you. That's the reason Psalm 119 verse 105, he said, your word is a light unto my feet. The word of God is a light into your feet, because it's not possible for you to know where to go in life until you have a light to see. Amen. So we all need that light, which is the word of God, to see where you're supposed to go in life. If I were to ask many of you who God called you to be, most of you may not know. But until you start spending time in the word of God, it's not possible for you to know who you are. And the fact that you don't know who you are is already called ignorance. And ignorance has a big price to pay. My people are perished because of what? And the verse continues to say, God reject them because they reject knowledge. So anyone who rejects knowledge, who doesn't understand something, you will pay a price for ignorance. Amen? Say, neighbor, don't be ignorant. See, those who despise the word shall be destroyed. And destroyed not because God will destroy you. Because once you don't know the word of God, the enemy will use you, will trick your life. So many of you, you wake up one day and you feel like you say, man, it's a bad day. Tell me when day used to be bad. If the day was bad, everyone will testify the same thing. How come you testify the day is bad, but this one says it's okay, it's a good day, I'm happy today? So it has nothing to do with day. It has to do with you, your personality. Something affects you. See, until you know what is destroying you, it's impossible to fight it. You cannot fight an enemy you cannot see. See, this is the ignorance that the enemy wants to plant in our mind for us not to understand the way he fights us. For you not to see. People believe the devil is a very ugly thing. But yet the Bible said it was very beautiful. They believe that when the enemy is coming, he's coming at them at a crazy way. Tell me how many times when you sin and when something happened to you, that he comes in a crazy way. Just to show you, your enemy is very smart. He knows what he's doing. And the only thing that can stop him is the word of what? Word of God. And if you don't know the word of God, then the enemy will destroy you. So some of us, we want to move forward with God. We want to go far with God. But the only thing that stops us is because we don't know the word. And there's something about the word that no one can teach you about it. And as you spend more time in the word, and the word itself become life. How many of you watch shows in this place with your hands? Please don't act like you don't watch shows. Just leave right. Shows, any kind of shows on TV. What happened when you start watching it? It's like it's going, trying to get at that for the show. You get to second episode, third one, fourth one. What happened there? You get stuck right there. Oh, you will miss work for that. Why? Because you get so into it. Why? Because you kept watching it. The same thing happened with the word of God. When you start reading it, you will fall asleep. All kind of things will happen to you. For some reason, your mind will tell you, will play tricks on you. All kind of tricks will happen. Why? Because the Bible said in the book of Hebrews that the soul does not mingle with the spirit. The soul doesn't like the things of the spirit. The Bible is a thing of the spirit. So your soul will tell you, it's better that you read a long book. Just get another book you read. But the Bible, no. How many times you read a book and you can spend 2 hours and read a book, and when you get to the Bible, you can't even read one page in the Bible. But give you any other book, you will read it, and it's, oh, this book, in the first page, they talk about this, or the next chapter, they talk about this. But when you get to the Bible, you can see nothing. It's like you read the first line, and you forget the first line when you get to the second one. So what were you reading again? And you forgot. You know why? Because the soul doesn't mingle with the spirit. The soul will fight you just to show you you're wasting time as you read the Bible. But guess what? The word is doing something to your spirit. The word somehow is affecting your spirit. It's impacting your spirit. Some people always ask me, what is the secret? How do you see in the spirit? How can you tell something? How can you just see someone and you know something? Like this girl come to me the other day. What happened? And she was telling me a story about a person, and I gave her the name of the person. How did I do that? How do you know a name of a person you never met? How can you do that? It has nothing to do with magic, with anything, all in the word of God. Have you ever read it in the book of Acts? It said, you're going to go to the street. When you get to the street, you're going to turn left. When you turn left, you will see a house. And when you get to the house, you will meet a man, they call him Saul. That's in the word of God. So why can this word happen now? Why can God speak to us today and to tell us things? It's because we're not spending enough time in the word of God. The Bible said in the book of Hebrews chapter 13 verse 7, it says, imitate the faith of the people in the old days. Because these people, they had a lot of faith. It says, imitate the same faith they had. And it continues to say in verse 8, because why? Jesus Christ is the same. Remember the word of God. Spend time in the word at first. You need a good job. You need to have a good husband. You need a good wife. You need to have nice children and a lot of things you want to have in life. Start with the word and tell me how your life goes. Because my Bible tells me God will supply all my need according to his riches and glory to Christ Jesus. Philippians 1:6, it says, the God that starts something in you, he will be the one that finish it as well. God never stopped anything to leave it alone. It's us that stay away from him. Because if he starts something, he will surely finish it. But for him to finish it, you cannot leave him as well. Some of you pray hard for something. When you get it, you forget about God. I've seen people like that. They pray hard for God to give them a husband or a wife. Right after they have the husband, now they're too busy for God. They enjoy that husband. When you tell them, how come you didn't come to service? Oh, we had a honeymoon on Fridays. on Fridays we have honeymoons. Before they didn't have honeymoons on Friday. But now every Friday is honeymoon. Until when you stop and you see them. I had a lady that used to be in the church like that. Every time you see her, she come. I say, oh Lord, something is wrong. Something is wrong. Every time you see her. What? I already know something wrong. That's not the Holy Spirit. I know. Because that's the only way she would come and do that. And after service, Pastor, I need prayer. I need prayer. I said, and I'm like, the man is acting up again. She said, yes, yes. How did you know? I know because that's the same thing that happened over and over. So, some people, that's the way they are. They're waiting when things go crazy, and that's when for them to seek the face of God. Don't allow this to happen to you. Amen. Don't wait when things go upside down. That's when you're going to try to seek God. Believe me, in your troubles, it's hard to seek the face of God. It's hard. But when you start reading the word of God, for some reason, you become a tool for God to use. The minute you start using the word of God, and then the enemy will use you. And when the enemy uses you, he doesn't use you for witchcraft at first. He just takes the word. He will use the word and take it away little by little. You think you have the word in your mind, but because you're not spending time in it, and he's taking it away. And by the time you become a good Christian, you don't even know. Yeah, you become a big.